السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, حياكم الله my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. This video I'm going to speak about brother Mohammed Hijab. نسأل الله السلامة والعافية. Mohammed Hijab has been established. Historically speaking, he cannot withhold his tongue against the ulama of Sunnah and Tawheed, those who spread Tawheed and Sunnah everywhere and warn against the shirk and the bid'ah. The most important thing is the Tawheed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the most dangerous thing is associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship or lordship or names and attributes. So, Muhammad Hijab, someone sent me a clip mocking one of the great scholars of Al-Islam, and that is Al-Imam Mohammed ibn Abdul Wahhab. May Allah have mercy upon him. And please, even if you dislike Ibn Abdul Wahhab or you dislike me, we have to be just. Allah said, وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَعْدِيلُ. Wallahi, even if he's a non-believer and a brother said something wrong about him and lied against him, as a Muslim, we should stand with the non-Muslim against our brother. And in reality, we are standing with our brother too. By what? By stopping him from his oppression against a non-Muslim. But if the truth is with a non-Muslim, we have to say, yes, you are a non-Muslim, yes, no doubt. He's a Muslim, our brother. However, you're right and our brother is wrong, let alone a Muslim. So please listen how hatred can blind people. It's unbelievable. Wallahi, it's aib. Wallahi, like Nabi alayhi salatu wassalam qal, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Whosoever believes in Allah and the last day, let him say something which is good or be quiet, be silent. Let us hear how Muhammad Hijab is belittling. Unbelievable how he, on his live stream, he was belittling Imam Muhammad al-Wahhab and his works. And to show you, this man is a man of injustice. He lies openly. Because he knows his followers will not go back and verify. Some of them will do. Alhamdulillah, like people contacted me, told me, yeah, I should listen to him. After I verified, I knew this man is a liar. He's a person with guidance, you know. Watch this. So, look how he speaks about, I'm going to make comments, okay. Let us play how he speaks about Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. May Allah have mercy upon him.
Those books are not required for anyone's guidance. And I'll tell you that with all due respect, those books are in fact not required for anybody's guidance. The Usul al-Thalatha, yeah? The Usul al-Thalatha, if I bring you the...
So now, those books, Thalatha al-Usul al-Qawaid al-Arba'a, no one's in need of those books to be guided, yes? There's two types of guidance. There's Hidayah, Tawfiq, and Hidayah al-Irshad. There's guidance, which is changing the heart, that no one has it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's a challenging Hidayat Irshad. You show people the way. This is the correct way. This is what Allah said. Prophet Muhammad SAW said. The companions said. You know, the ulama, the scroll sunnah said, and so on. And this is for the prophets and messengers before, conveyed the message, and also for them. From the ulama and the du'at. And there's Hidayah, which changed the heart that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hidayat Tawfiq. And now, those books, historically speaking, many people, Allah guided people throw these books. I'm one of them. Like people have doubt about shirk because no one has written about Kitab Tawheed al-Uluhiyya in details like Imam Muhammad al-Wahhab. Because he noticed during his lifetime there was a lot of doubt about it. Shirk spread. Even my country, I remember. You know, al-Wali is someone you cannot disrespect. We're scared of the Wali. You're bringing doubt and shubuhat after reading the works of Muhammad al-Wahhab, and after I read the Quran correctly, subhanallah, what is this? But why Muhammad al-Wahhab's books have guided many people? Not because of Muhammad al-Wahhab, because his books full of the Quran, ayat and ahadith, ya Muhammad. But you haven't read the book. Because if you read the book, listen to his next statement to show you have not read the book. Oh Allah, because of his deep hatred against the Imam Muhammad al-Wahhab, what happened? He couldn't see the ayat and the ahadith. Watch. So he said no. And that can apply to any book. Say, okay. The books of Abu Hassan Ash'ari. The books of Al-Baqillani. the books of Abu al-Ma'al al-Juwayni, the books of Ibn Fawrak, the books of Ibn Taymiyyah, the books of any alim, the books of Ibn Hajar Asqalani, Sharh. No one has any of those books to be guided. Who speaks like that? When those books, Ibn Hajar Asqalani's book or Ibn Taymiyyah's books, full of ahadith and ayat, showing the people the correct way of refuting the doubt. Subhanallah. That's Allah salama wa al-afiyya. But this man who has a deep hatred, because according to his logic, that can apply to any book then. I don't have to read any book that was written by any Ash'ari scholars. The Ash'aris don't read hadith wahad enough according to Muhammad Hijab. Well, listen to this.
The Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if I bring you I bring you one hadith of the Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, one hadith, which is where the angels were, they ask him, man rabbuka wa ma dinuka, whatever. If I put that in a pamphlet, it will be better than 1,000 Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam books of Abdul Wahhab. Because it's the kalam of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
He said, if I put one hadith of Munkir and Nakir, three questions, in one pamphlet or leaflet, will be better, 1,000 times better than the three usul qawaid arba, yeah? Guess what? Wallahi, this man is a kadhab. Do you know why? Either he believes in the Quran and the other ahadith, because let us read what is in the three usul. Let us read. Maybe Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, maybe Muhammad Hijab was reading a book about cooking, and it talks about black paper, and it calls, maybe the title of the book is Thalathal Usul, and it's mixing, and that book was talking about black paper and cumin and turmeric and salad and how you cook and so on. He got mixed up, miskin. The book, first page, he speaks about al-ilm. He says, what is knowledge? It's to know Allah, to know His Messenger, and to know Islam, with the proofs. Then he goes on to mention what? وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. So Muhammad Hijab, come out openly and tell us, are you saying one hadith, according to you, because Quran and hadith, we don't compare them, you know? Of course, Allah's statements above, no doubt. طيب, the Quran. Now, are you saying one hadith is better than writing 1,000 times or reading 1,000 times of Surah Al-Asr? You see how you hold your tongue. You see how you always lead yourself to destruction. Okay, is it only Surah Al-Asr? No. There's Surah Fa'alam Annahu La Ilaha Illallah, the most important thing, which is Tawheed. The Surah Muhammad, verse number 19. He quotes a verse. Then he quotes Imam Shafi'i's statement. Then he quotes another verse. Then he quotes another verse. Tayyib. وَعْبُودُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِشَيْءَ. Muhammad Hijab. So are you telling us one hadith is better than 1,000 times reading وَعْبُودُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِشَيْءَ? He's going to say no. No, that's what you are saying. Even though you haven't said it. But your statement, يُلْزِمُكَ هَذَا. Because by implication of your speech, that this book, which has many verses, many ahadith, is nothing. You might just put it in the bin, وَالْعِيَدُ بِاللَّهِ نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. The way he's speaking about the book. So the book that was written by Imam, scholar, ulama praised him, Imam Albani praised him. Yes, Imam Albani said he was not strong in hadith. Some scholars also said Abu Hanifa was not strong in hadith. Okay, some scholars even tried to say Imam Ahmed was not faqih. Okay, we don't blind follow. Barakallahu fiikum. So the shahid here, Imam Albani praised him. He said he was strong in aqidah, in tawheed, and he had a great impact on his land and other Muslim countries. But the people of misguidance, they took a 49-second video, tried to misguide the Muslims. Anyway, so this book, which is full of ayat and ahadith, is nothing, according to Muhammad Hijab. Subhanallah. That shows he has not read it. He has not read the book. How many people Allah guided them through this book? Why Allah guided them through this book? Because this book is full of Quran and Sunnah and the speech of Sahaba, and not just this book, other books as well, and the ulama of Sunnah, and that is the barakah of the Quran and Sunnah. And you can see when our brothers CC Dawah around the world, they give Dawah, people accept Shahada straight away. Why? Is it because CC Dawah? No, because they Dawah based upon Quran and Sunnah. You, Muhammad Hijab, how many people you speak to? Always falsafa. Rare when you see someone taking Shahada. Why? Because there's no barakah in falsafa. Subhanallah. And let me ask you something. You have, what I can see, there is a library behind you. What are you doing with those books? I don't believe those books is hadith or Quran. That's books of philosophers maybe. go bend them. One hadith enough. Get one hadith that you want to put in and put it there and bend all the books. Implement what you're preaching. Tayyip?
If I author a book today and I just put that hadith in it with some note in the bottom, it will be better than 1,000 usul al-thalatha books. Because it has the comprehensive how the Prophet dealt with the three questions. Who's better at understanding the three questions, Abdul Wahhab or the Prophet Muhammad?
You know, he's ignorant. You know, he said, now I'm going to belittle Imam Abdul Wahhab. But don't worry, my brothers and sisters. Ayyuha al-Muslimun, la takhafun. Ibn Taymiyyah of his time is here. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali is here. Ibn Mubarak is here. Who? Muhammad Hijab. He's going to save the Ummah now. Tayyib, forget Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. I'm going to save you. So if he authors a book with the hadith of Munkar and Nakir and he makes footnotes, it will be 1,000 times better than a book that is full of ayat and hadith and speech of ulama of Salaf. So Imam Shafi'i, forgive us. Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, Muhammad Hijab, khalas, finished you, my brother. You're finished. Shafi'i, you're finished, brother. Allah is a calamity. Wallahi, this man is a calamity. People say you is a calamity. Do you know why? A book that is full of Quran, a hadith, ayat and a hadith. You speak about it like this? But a book that is full of falsafa, you go and glorify it and praise it? To show you this man has an evil agenda. Wal'iyadu billah. May Allah protect the Muslim from his evilness. Wal'iyadu billah. He said, why? If you write the book, because his book has the hadith of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I don't know that Surat Al-Asr belongs to whom. I don't know who revealed Surat Al-Asr according to him. I mean, the other ayat in this book, I don't know, is Kalam Man. Kalam Man is a speech of whom? Speech of Allah. But according to Muhammad Hijab, Allah's speech is nothing. Wal'iyadu billah. One hadith is 1,000 times better than Allah's speech and all those verses and so on. May Allah save us.
Tell me now. I want any Salafi to come and tell me no, Abdul Wahhab was better so I can make takfir of them.
Look at him. Look at this arrogance. Who has better understanding? Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam better in understanding. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam or Abdul Wahhab? Come on. I'm here, Muhammad Hijab. Come on. Come, Salafis, come. And tell me something. I'll make takfir on you. He's a clown. But I don't understand how this clown is deceiving people. But why I'm surprised when you have a bigger clown, his teacher, yes, Al Qadi deceived many Muslims. So there's no surprise. Allah al Musta'an. But anyway, according to his logic, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, Rahimahullah Ta'ala, I can say same thing. Okay, who's better in understanding? Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam or Fakhruddin al Razi? Or Ibn Mubarak, from the Salaf? Who speaks like that? Which ulama of the Salaf or even Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, you saying this is my understanding? Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is bringing you the ayat and the ahadith to tell you how this hadith can be understood in light of the Quran and the Sunnah. Like Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, when he said, قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. What is the meaning of it? You have to be مخلص. What is the proof? Sheikh Islam Abdul Wahhab is other hadith. من قال لا إله إلا الله مخلص من قلبه. He's not saying my opinion, Muhammad Hijab. So Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, may Allah have mercy upon him on one side. He always back up his claim with Quran and Sunnah. The Salaf, Sahaba and the Salaf, and the A'imma of Al-Islam. Muhammad Hijab on the other side. My opinion, I think. But who should we follow? Him. Mean Muhammad Hijab. He's a calamity. Now is another one.
Do you take from Muhammad Abdul Wahhab?
No.
At all?
At all.
Anything?
Nothing.
Of course, no. I'm Muhammad Hijab, brother. I'm Ibn Daqiq Al-Eid sitting with you, my brother. Respect yourself. Ibn Daqiq Al-Eid, you're talking to him. Come on. He's asking him, do you take no from fiqh? No. And watch his excuses to show you he has an evil hatred against Imam Muhammad Al-Wahhab.
Nothing.
Why?
I believe.
Have you noticed? I believe my opinion. If people give me money, just as much as Muhammad Hijab says, I believe my opinion, I'll be more richer than what's his name, this guy who just Twitter, Elon Musk, or I'll be more richer than him.
But I believe that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab was a Hanbali. I believe he was a Hanbali, but he wasn't a marja in the Hanbali madhab.
Which means for our viewers,
he wasn't a reference. Simple as that. He's not a reference.
Oh, simple as that. Come on, man. Why are you asking Muhammad Hijab? Imam Ibn Taymiyyah? Why are you asking Imam al-Falsafa, al-Khalsafa, al-Khalsafa? or you're asking this man. You should ask him, tell him, simple as that, khalas, yakfi. Now Ali, Muhammad Hijab is going to Saudi, go with him and ask him. Tell him, let's go to Sheikh Fawzan, tell him, you said, what you, and translate to him in Arabic. I don't really don't translate it. I've translated already, take the video, tell him this brother, I'm against him. Brother Shamsi, against him. And he is defending Muhammad Abdul Wahhab against Muhammad Hijab, who's belittling Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. Please do that for us, barakallahu fi, because you keep talking. Do that, do this for us. So, he's not point of reference. So Sheikh Fawzan, go to Sheikh Fawzan, say, yes, Sheikh, tell Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, Imam Abdul Wahhab, we don't go back to him in fiqh. He's not a person of fiqh. You know, he's no one to him. Look, his excuse. But the brother, subhanAllah, may Allah guide the brother, he said to him, what about aqidah then?
He's not even seen as a scholar of the madhab. He's not seen as authoritative in the least. So there's no need for me to go to his fatawa on fiqh masail, especially.
He's not a scholar in madhab al-Hanbali. He's not. So Sheikh Fawzan, Sheikh Al-Husayn al-Abbad, Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh Al-Thaymin, they're no one. We're going to listen to Muhammad Hijab. So please, Ali Dawah, do me a favor, please. Do your brother, beloved brother, please. Go Sheikh Fawzan, tell him, translate this video. We help you translate, because I know we don't know Arabic. We translate if you take it to because you said whatever Muhammad Hijab says, hold me for it.
What about creedal matters?
No, there's no need for that. He's not an expert logician or an expert.
What about aqidah? No, there's no need for that. Come on. I'm Ash'ari, my brother. He's an Ash'ari. I'm Mukhita Baiti business. How are you going to ask me to go to someone who is da'wah upon pure tawheed, following the sunnah, ta'adim al-Qur'an wa sunnah? Me, I'm faylasuf, ya akhi. How can you tell me? I'm a philosopher. You know, I'm doing PhD in Oxford University to prove Allah's existence. Like, please. So you need a PhD to know Allah exists or not? To prove Allah's existence. It's Allah salamu al-afiyah. To show you this man has inferiority complex. So why does he always belittle the ulama of sunnah and he always raise either the Western scholars or those who influenced by the Western scholars like Yasser Qadi or Jonathan Brown and so on. The Shaykh Barakallahu Fikum, to conclude, Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, may Allah have mercy upon him. Many scholars praise him. The last Imam Albani, may Allah have mercy upon him. Yes, Imam Albani said he was not strong in hadith. That's his opinion. There are some scholars who said Abu Hanifa was not strong in hadith. Tayyib. But Imam Albani, he praised him. He said his da'wah was strong. You know, may Allah have mercy upon him because of Shaykh al-Islam. And we have Muhammad Hijab, who tried to belittle him and make his books like nothing. Which books? That full of Quran and Sunnah and the Salaf. To show you this man, he has a deep hatred. All those books behind him, please don't show them anymore. Go ban them. One hadith is enough. Use your, implement your preach, implement your da'wah. We stop here. Allah salama wa al-afiyah. Alhamdulillah, it's becoming more clearer for those who have sight, I mean physical sight, and the sight of the heart to see this man is a person of misguidance. Of misguidance. He does not want Angus to shrink in details. He does not want Angus innovations. He always just attacks Ahl Sunnah al-Jama'ah. He cooperates with Dubendis, he cooperates with everyone, al-iyadu billah. When we say cooperate with everyone, what is the problem? You cooperate with everyone, you go against the way of the Salaf. The way of the Salaf to be upon a clarity. In a deen, I'm talking about a deen. To be upon a clarity. You don't cause confusion. Yeah, okay, if someone, because we have to mention that. Someone say, yeah, but if Ash'ari or a non-Muslim, his house burning, I should not cooperate to help him who have the building? No, please, don't talk about this. Coexistence has nothing to do with what we're talking about. Cooperate in deen. So please, no, you're helping. Even non-Muslim, you see his house been burning, go help him. Barakallahu feekum. We stop here. وصلى الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم سليما كثيرا.